Hello. In this video, we will learn how to apply the principle of squash and stretch to your Alight Motion animations. Squash and stretch describes the changes in shape a flexible object goes through as it moves, in a way that mimics real life. A common example is that of a bouncing ball, as can be seen in the animation we will create today. The ball stretches as it gains speed, and it gets squashed when it hits the paddle. It returns to its original shape when it reaches the top of its arc. It does all of this while appearing to retain its overall volume, which makes the animation believable. Let's see how we can use this in Alight Motion. If you would like to follow along, you can download the project packages from the link in the description. We're going to start with the project you see here. We have a background layer and a ping pong paddle. The paddle was created in Alight Motion, and it's available for use in the project packages. Let's create our ball and then animate it. First, let's add a circle to our project and change the color. Let's go to Move and Transform, then to the Scale property and reduce the size of our ball. Let's position it somewhere near the top of the project. Let's also trim our layer in time to match the duration of the paddle animation. Let's add some animation to this ball. While the ball layer is selected, go to Move and Transform and add two position keyframes, one at the beginning and one at the end of the layer. We want to create a looping animation, so we need the ball to be at the same place at the beginning and the end of the animation. It's easiest to do this now, before we have moved the ball. Now, place the playhead at the halfway point in time and move the ball down so it touches the paddle surface. Another position keyframe should be created automatically at this time. If we play through our animation now, the ball will drop down to the paddle and then bounce back up, which is what we want. But the motion is not natural. While the ball is falling down, it should start slow and hit the paddle at full speed. While bouncing up, the ball should do the opposite. The easing curve we select should reflect this. With position still selected in Move and Transform, move the playhead between the first two keyframes, tap the easing button, and let's choose the easing preset shown here, and tweak it a bit to suit our needs. For the second half of the animation, we can choose the opposite preset and tweak it in the same way. Now, when we play the animation, we can see that the ball starts slow and gains speed on the way to the paddle, and then slows as it rises again, which is much more realistic. To learn more about easing, please see our video on the topic. At this point, our ball is moving well, but let's make it more visually appealing by applying the principle of squash and stretch. We'll do this by giving the ball a vertical stretch while it's moving quickly, and we'll squash it as it hits the paddle. Let's start with the stretch. Tap on the circle layer, go to Effects, then Add Effects. Navigate to the Move Transform section, select the Stretch Axis effect, and tap Standard Settings. As the title of the effect suggests, this allows us to stretch our layer out in one direction. We want a vertical stretch, so let's make the value of angle 90 degrees. We can apply the stretch by increasing the scale value. At the beginning, we don't want any stretch, because the ball is just floating at the top of the bounce. Let's add a scale keyframe here. As the ball falls, it should start to stretch. So, let's go a couple of frames forward and then increase the value of the scale until the ball looks appropriately stretched. Now, let's go forward and place the playhead here when the ball hits the paddle and reduce the stretch back to 1 so that it regains its shape. We'll then apply the easing presets you see on screen. At this point, you can see when it falls, it stretches, and then regains its original shape. This is not quite right, though. When the ball is longer, it should also be narrower, so that volume is conserved at all times. This is easy to do with what we've already created. Simply tap this icon and select Duplicate. On the duplicated effect, we should set the angle back to zero because we want to squeeze the ball horizontally. Tap Scale and move the playhead to the time of the second keyframe. It will highlight in green. Keyframes that are highlighted in green can be edited. At this point, simply decrease the value of scale to make the ball more narrow. If we play this back, we can see our stretch in action. The ball maintains its original volume and the animation feels organic. With our stretch done, it's time to add our squash animation when the ball hits the paddle. To do this, we're going to add the squeeze effect from the distortion warp category with standard settings. Let's place the playhead just one frame before the ball hits the paddle and add a keyframe for strength. Next, let's move one frame ahead and increase the strength. It should look like the paddle is squashing the ball. Now, go forward on the timeline to where the ball is just leaving the paddle. Bring the strength back to zero and apply this easing curve preset. You can see when the ball hits the paddle, it will be squeezed and then regain its original shape as it moves up. Our ball is looking great. Now it's time to add animation to the paddle to make it convincingly hit the ball. We can do this by making a loop animation where the paddle bends towards the ball with each bounce. Let's select the paddle layer, tap Effects, Add Effects, go to the Distortion Warp section, and select the Bend effect with standard settings. With Origin set to Bottom, we can change the angle of the effect and see how the paddle can bend. Let's reset the effect to the default values. Let's add an angle keyframe at the beginning and the end of our project to set up our loop. Before the paddle hits the ball, let's bend the paddle downwards in anticipation and add a keyframe. When the ball reaches the paddle, we can bend it in the opposite direction and add another keyframe. These four keyframes together will define three different parts of the animation. Let's apply easing to make these motions appear more natural. We want the paddle to start slow and then hit the ball quickly, then slow back down again. We'll move the playhead between the first two keyframes and add the easing curve preset shown on screen. We can then tap the right arrow in the easing panel to go to the next segment, where we can add this preset. And finally, tap the right arrow again and add this preset. If we play everything back, we can see our whole animation come together. Let's check out the same animation without squash and stretch and without the bend by disabling all of the effects. You can see it looks very dull. There's no life in the animation. But if we turn the effects back on, you can see the animation looks much smoother and more professional. In this video, we showed you how you can use the stretch axis and squeeze effects to help you create squash and stretch animations in a light motion. Try using this in your own projects and make sure to show us what you create by using the hashtag AMSquashStretch. If you have any questions, please make sure to ask in the comments. We'll do our best to help in any way we can.